Hey guys, this video is going to be a little bit different from what I've been doing so far. I got a comment in one of my videos about how to enter the industry. Like, I think he mentioned doing movies or like games. I mean, audio in general. So his name is, I don't know if I'm going to pronounce it right, Curran McQueen. I wanna answer his question, telling a little bit about my story. How do I got in the place that I am right now? I started as a drummer at the age of 16, so I played in many bands by the time. I wanted to be a musician. I always liked to play, to do shows. I actually did a bunch of shows in underground places in Brazil, and that was kind of nice. But I kind of realized that I wouldn't go so far with this kind of job. My first graduation was in sound engineer by the age of 19. So I got a first job in a studio recording artists, and that was really my first step into music technology. But I did find very technical, and I was kind of confused if I wanted to pursue that area, you know. So that's when I kind of changed a little bit my life and started a different graduation. And I did study philosophy for 5 years and graduated in that area. And I don't regret doing that at all because I really love it. And I feel like it added so much to my life in a personal level. And I'm glad I had this moment in my life. So I had to make a choice. I was so like in love with music and sounds. And I was like already doing stuff in my home studio. I wasn't really a gamer, but I remember my brother gave to me a magazine talking about music for games and talking about how this market was growing. And that was back in 2012 or like maybe 2013. So when he showed me that, I was like, yeah, that seems like a good idea because it's more than playing a band and having to depend on other people to follow your career. It's more like an independent way of doing things. I also thought about doing movies, and the whole visual media seems very attractive to me. That was the moment I realized, oh, like there are a lot of people working in this area. What do they do? What can I do with that? It might seem like destiny, but I had a teacher in philosophy that his brother was a major composer in Brazil. I sent him an email saying, "My name is Bettina. I like to compose. I want to show you my work." And by that time, I was already work doing freelancers for a game. And my first freelancer, I actually got it in a very crazy way because I actually called a company that was doing a lot of advert games. I said, "Hey, I'm a composer for games and I want to work with you," right? So I was totally like no shame at all. And I was like kind of desperate needing to start somehow, you know? So it was a really nice start because they were very receptive with me. It was my first time being paid to work with music. From that moment, I started to contact more developers in the area and mainly in Brazil. I decided to go to Vancouver to study in Vancouver Film School, and that was sound design for visual media. I actually had experiencing in the area, so I didn't really need to do the course, right? But like, of course, you are always learning, and I'm right now at the moment I'm still learning, and I'll be learning all my life. So it kind of gave me expanded my knowledge, especially like there were areas that I wasn't very aware of how it worked, like Foley, for instance, like production sound, and I was able to do those things, field recording, and that was kind of cool. I didn't know if I was able to stay there. I didn't get a work visa after it. So I was very, very fortunate to get a job with some company that is from Brazil. They transferred the company to Toronto, and they are a very good game company. Very small, very independent, but also like they had many successful titles released. In Brazil, I used to go to many events and to do network with people in the game area. So I did know a lot of people, and I knew that they were going to Canada, right? So that's when I wrote to them saying that I was there and I would love to work with them if they need audio. And I was able to stay there because of them. I got a work visa and I stayed there for more 2 years more. Now I'm in Brazil, but I was still working with them till, to be honest, last week. Actually, this month's gonna be my last month. Company went through a hard time, and now they really can't afford to pay everyone. So they are kind of reformulating the project that we were working for like almost 3 years. I worked there for 2 years, and yeah, but I just have so many good things to say about this company. It was my first experience working inside a game studio, right? Because it's different from working as a freelancer, because as a freelancer sometimes you don't have enough engagement with another areas, right? Like you do have to talk to the programmer, you do have to like know things, understand about the game, but it's so different to actually participate in the process, see the production every day, see how it works, the challenge behind it. And yeah, that for sure made me a way better professional, I think. So I'm really glad I had this opportunity. I just wanna end it talking about a little bit of the future of my YouTube channel. I know that I'm not like a very, very social media person. I'm very lazy of posting stuff, but like I do like YouTube because when I make a video, I have to study for that. And I did a bunch of videos that were tutorials. So that's the kind of stuff I like to do, actually. I want to do more videos about gaming audio. That is my area, right? So I'm thinking about making more sound design videos and tips and tricks that I've learned along the way. I've been doing that. I want to talk about middlewares. I want to talk about the process of implementing the audio in the game. And as I'll do that, I'll be learning a lot more. That's what I want to do, right? Like I might post something about music too, because I do love to compose, and I'll pretend to keep doing that. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. And yeah, I hope I can keep it up with this channel. Bye.